Hello and welcome back. So in my last video I talking about this example 10, which says that using the generating function solve the recurrence relation, which is given over here, an minus 7 an minus 1 plus 10 an minus 2 equals to 0. And this relation is true for all n greater than 1, and the initial value of the recurrence relation is given, which is a naught equals to 3 and a 1 is also 3. So we talk about the solution procedure, but I have not completed the whole video due to some technical issue. So today I going to decide I start from fresh, and we will talk about the solution from the beginning. So here we go. What we have to first decide it, we have to assume that let gx be a generating function of the sequence an. So let me do it over here. So here we have the recurrence relations, which is an. You can see that the nth term of the sequence an can be written as an equals to n minus 1 term plus 10 an minus 2 term. So this is also can be written in the equation given in the question, which is an minus 7 an minus 1 plus 10 an minus 2 equals to 0. In this form it was given in your question. So what is the solution procedure? So solution procedure is, we first have to assume that let gx be our generating function. So we assume that gx, which is our generating function, you can see that in your note, you can see that gx be the generating function of the sequence an. And gx, we assume that gx is the infinite series, which is an equals to 0 to infinity an x to the power n. So let me write it more openly, means I want to write more explicit form. So for that case, if I put n equals to 0 over here, so we get a 0 x to the power 0 plus the summation, means plus we have to put n equals to 1, so it will be a 1 x to the power 1 plus, next we have to put n equals to 2 x square, and so on. In this way it is going, the series, infinite series going on in this way. So this is becomes a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square plus a 3 x cube, and so on. In this way this summation is going on. So gs is our generating function. I already talk about the generating function for a sequence. So generating function of the sequence an, and we have to find the value of an from here. So from this equation we have to find the value of an. So what we're going to do next, let me write down the equation first. So here we have the equation an minus 7 an minus 1 plus 10 an minus 2, which is equals to 0. Now we're going to multiply both sides. So you can see from here the next step is multiplying 1 by x to the power n. So first we're going to multiply the equation by x to the power n. So what we get, x to the power n into an minus 7 an minus 1 plus 10 an minus 2 equals to x to the power n into 0. So from there you can see that it becomes an x to the power n minus 7 an minus 1 x to the power n. We basically multiply x to the power n, so or to each term, then we get 10. So I have written 10 two times, so I'm sorry for that. So 10 a to the power a 2 n minus 1 x to the power n, and x to the power n into 0 is 0. So next step is, you can see from here, next step is summing the each term from n equals to 2 to infinity, which means let me write that down. So here we have to erase this part. What we're going to do, we put the value from n equals to 2. So why we put n equals to 2? Because the equation, the recurrence relation is true for n greater than 1. So you can see that recurrence relation is true for n greater than 1, which means it's true for n greater than equals to 2. So we put first n equals to 2 over here in the equation 1. So we put n equals to 2 over here in equation 1. What we get? We get a 2 x square minus 7 a 1 x square plus 10 a naught x square equals to 0. So now this is our equation 2. Next we're going to put n equals to 3. So what we get? A 3 x cube minus 7 a 2 x cube plus 10 a 1 x cube equals to 0. This is our equation 3. Next we put n equals to 4, n equals to 5, and so on. After that we add all such equation, means we add 2 3 4 5 6. So we going to add all such equation. So after adding all such equation, we basically get, so you can do it by yourself. So after adding all such infinite number of terms, we will get a sequence in this form, that in which is start from n equals to 2 to infinity a n x to the power n minus 7 summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 1 x to the power n plus, it will become 10 into summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 2 x to the power n, which is equals to 0. So after adding all such term, the equation will be in this form. So you can see that, which also written over here. So after adding all such term, we get summation n equals to 2 to infinity a 1 x to the power n minus 7, and so on. In this way you can get all such term over there. So next what we're going to do, we will first taking this term and we will work with this term. So first taking, let me take this term over here. So what we get over here? So take summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n x to the power n. Now if we write in more explicit form, so first we put n equals to 2 over here. So we can write a 2 x square. Next it will be 3 x cube plus a to the power 4 x to the power 4 plus, so on in this way. So this is one of our part. And another part I want you to remember, that gx is a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square plus a cube x cube, and so on. If you compare this series with this series, you can see that clearly that these two term are missing over here. These two term a naught plus a 1 x are not over here. So we're going to add these two term. So a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square, and so on. So extra term what we added over here, we will have to subtract that part. So a naught minus a 1 into x. So now this term is clearly equals to gx. So we can write over here. So we can write, so let me write that down. So we can write over here gx minus a naught minus a 1 x. So you can clearly see from our note that you get something n equals to 0 to infinity a n x to the power n, which is gx minus a naught minus a 1 x. So over there we get this term equals to this value. Next we work with the second term. So let me erase this part and work with the second term. So here we go. So I have to erase this part. So we work with going to work with this second term. So second term is I just let it over here, 7 over here, and work with the summation part only. So summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 1 x to the power n. Now put the value of n, what we get? We get here, if I put n equals to 2, we get 2 minus 1, which is a 1. Here we get x square plus we will get x 2 when we going to put n equals to 3. So x 2 x cube plus a 3 x to the power 4 and so on. In this way the series is going on. Now what we going to have here, in the coefficient of x we have a 1, in the coefficient of x square we have a 2. So what we going to do over here, we going to take x outside of the summation. We get a 1 x plus a 2 x square plus a 3 x cube. So after taking x outside of the summation we get something like that, but it's still not equals to gx. To have this is equals to gx, we have to add a naught. So we have to add a naught over here. So what we do here, we add a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square and so on. So adding term over there have to be subtracted, so we subtract a naught from there. So now this summation is gx, so we get basically x into gx minus, so I have to write it somewhere else. So we get x into gx, so what we get x into gx minus a naught. So second term will be in this form, x into gx minus a naught. You can see from here also. So in this over here you can see that my second term is almost like gx minus a naught, which is a naught is 3. So you can see that gx minus 3. I want to rectify one more thing. So here you can see that I have written a n minus 2 minus 7 x summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 2. It's not a n minus 2, it's have to be a n minus 1. So it's a mistake when I am writing from here to here, so it's have to be a n minus 1. So you can see that it's already there in a n minus 1 form in the next step. So for now we going to work with the third step. So we work with the third part or the third portion of the equation. So first let me erase this part. So here we go. Now I just want to leave 10 over here and work with the summation part. So after working with the summation, what we get? So here we have n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 2 x to the power n. Now we put the value of n over here. So put n equals to 2, first we get a naught x square. Next we put n equals to 3, so what we get? A 1 x cube. Next put n equals to 4, we get 2 a 2 x 4 and so on. So now you can clearly see that the coefficient of x square here is a 2, but here coefficient of x square is a naught, but coefficient of a naught is 1 over here. So what we going to do, we will take x square out of this summation. So x square will be out, then we get a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square plus in this way. You can see that if I take x square common, so here will be 1, here will be 3 minus 2 which is x, here will be 4 minus 2 which is 2, and in this way. Now we can see that this is x square and this term is clearly the gx, so we get gx square gx. So you can see from here that we get 10x square gx. So from here you get gx minus 3 minus 3x minus 7x gx minus 3 plus 10x square gx. So what we do over here, we take gx common from here. So after working with that, if we take gx common, we get 10x square minus 7x. So you may ask, how I get 3 and 3 minus from here, how we get 3 minus 3x? We actually put the value of a naught. a naught is 3 and a1 is 3, so we get gx minus. So if I let me do it in over here, so what we get over here, so from there let me do it over here more fresh way that you can understand the each and every step of the problem, so of the solutions procedure you can understand each and every step. So here we go, so what we get from there, so what we have and what we get. So here we have summation, after summation we get n equals to 2 to infinity a n x to the power n minus 7 summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 1 x to the power n plus 10 into summation n equals to 2 to infinity a n minus 2 x to the power n equals to 0, and after the calculations work with the summation, what we get, here we get gx minus a naught minus a1 x minus 7 x, here we get gx minus a naught, and here we get 10 x square into gx. That's what we get after working with this each and every summation. Now we have a naught equals to 3 and a1 is 3. We're going to put the value of a naught and a1, so we get gx minus 3 minus 3x minus 7x. Gx is gx, so minus a naught is 3 plus 10 x square gx. So what we're going to do now, we'll take gx term or one direction and other side. So gx here is the coefficient is 10x square, so we're going to write 10x square. Here the coefficient of gx is minus 7x, so we're going to write minus 7x. Here the coefficient of gx is 1, so we're going to write plus 1, and other coefficient is over here is minus 3 minus 3x, so minus 3 plus 7x is 21x equals to 0. So what we get gx into 10x square minus 7x plus 1. Here if I take this in this side, so we get 3 minus 19x, I think so it will be 3 minus 19x, oh it's a 18x, 3 minus 18x, because 18 plus 3, yeah, 18 plus 3 is 21, so it's going to be 18x over here. So gx is, so here it is square, so gx becomes gx equals to 3 minus 18x by 10x square minus 7x plus 1. So let me erase this part and let me write that down. So what we get from here, so I'm taking your time, but I have to do it. Okay, I hope you understand the solution procedure. If you not, just ask me the questions where you have the difficulties. So what we get gx, so here we get gx which is equals to 3 minus 18x by 10x square minus 7x plus 1. Now we're going to factorize 10x square minus 7x plus 1. So what we can write from here, we can write 10x square minus 5x minus 2x plus 1. So we can take 5x common, so we get 2x minus 1. So here we take minus 1, so 2x minus 1. So it becomes 5x minus 1 and is 2x minus 1. So what we get from here, we get 3 minus 18x over here, and we have 5x minus 1 but 2x minus 1. So here we go, this is will be our gx. So you can see that we already get over there, so here you can see that we get this part over there. So now if I factorize again, we will get something like that. So if I, it is the matter of a few more calculations to do. From there you can obviously find this part. From there, if you take the LCM of these two, minus 1/5x minus 1 and 1/2x minus 1, you will get something like that. Or you can do it by taking going through all this process what you have already done in your module, in your actually in your semester 1 when you are working with some integrations. So where you already, you already use this type of formula. So from there, or you can do it by yourself. So what we going to have, so let me write that down. So what we have, so what we want to do over here, we want to write something what we can. So here we get 1 minus 5x minus 1 minus, so minus 4/2x minus 1. So how I have done this thing, so you can, I think you know already. If you not, and just do it by yourself. If you find difficulty, then ask me later on. So we get 1/5x minus 1 minus, so let me do it for a few steps for you. What we go from here, we get, you can see it's get 2x minus 1 minus 4 into 5x minus 1. So what we have, 2x minus 1 minus 20x plus 4. So from there we get, you can clearly see that we get minus 3 minus 80x, which is in the upper part. So if you do not know how to do it, so let me give you one suggestion to solve it. So what you have to do, you have to write this 18x by 5x minus 1 minus 2x minus 1 equals to, because we have the degree, highest degree is 1, here also we have the highest degree 1. So you have to write in this form, a by 5x minus 1 plus b by 2x minus 1. So from there what you can get, we can have to take the LCM 5x minus 1, 2x minus 1, and we get a minus 2x minus 1 plus b into 5x minus 1. So from now what we're going to do, you have to compare 3 minus 80x with a minus 2x plus b into 5x minus 1. I'm sorry. So if you compare this, you will get something like that. A will be your 1 and B will be minus 4. So I just give you the hints, do it by yourself. If I have to do it, it's take a longer and longer time, and we maybe get outside of the actual equation. So I hope you understand. If you not, if you find difficulty, so comment me below. I will do it for yourself in my next video. So here we go. So we get something like that. Now what we're going to do, we will take, so we will do something like that. So what we're going to do over here, we will take minus or 5x minus 1 whole to the power minus 1 minus 4 2x minus 1 whole to the power minus 1, or you can just take a minus outside, then you can write 1 minus 2x whole to the power minus 1 minus 1 minus 5x whole to the power minus 1. You can see from over here that we get something like that. 4 into 1 minus 2x minus 1 minus minus 1 minus 5x whole to the power minus 1. Now we going to use the formula of minus 1. So if you know that, then if you just use this formula, so formula was that, if we have something like that. So let me repeat you repeat the formula for you. Suppose 1 minus a minus 1, so this will becomes a plus a 1 plus a plus x square plus a cube. In this way, this is the formula. So here you have a is actually a, here also a is a. So if I put this formula, so what we get from here, so let me write that down. So erase this part and write that down. So write that down. So here we go. Here we get 4 into 1 plus 2x plus 2x whole square and so on, minus 1 plus 5x plus 5x whole square, 5x whole cube, in this way. So if I write in more summation form, so this becomes, first let me write 2 into x plus 2 square x square, then it will be 2 cube x cube and so on, and here you can see it will be 1 plus 5 into x plus 5 square x square plus 5 cube x cube plus so on. So what we get, our first term, it will be, so it will be something like that. So first term is 3 plus second term will be 2 minus 5x, third term will be 2 square plus 5 square x square, third term will be 2 cube minus 5 cube x cube and so on. So if I write in a more compact form or close form, so what we get from here, we get summation n equals to, so you can see from here, so it start from over here, you can see it will becomes 2 to the power n minus 2. So we have, actually I forget about the 4, sorry for that. So it will becomes 2 into n plus 2 minus 5 and something like that. So I actually forget about 4. So what is a 4 over here? So here we have 4 basically. So I'm sorry for that. So let me erase this part and write it down more fresh way. So what we get from there, so here we have 4 can be written as 2 square. So 4 can be written as 2 square. So first term is 2 square. So it can be written as 2 square plus 2, 1 plus 2 x plus 2, 2 plus 2 x square plus 2, 2 plus 3 plus 2, 3 plus 2 x cube and so on. And here we have minus 1 plus 1 can be written as 5 to the power 0, something like that. So 5 to the power 1 x plus 5 square x square plus 5 cube x cube plus so on. If I take common, so what we get from here, so you can write something like that. So here we can write it as 2 to the power 0 plus 2 minus 5 to the power 0 plus 2 to the power 1 plus 2 minus 5 to the power 1 into x plus 2 to the power, why I'm writing all such a way, because I want to find a pattern. So it will be 2 plus 2 minus 5 square x square and so on. So you can see that this summation becomes, so after calculating all these parts, the summation becomes, so here we go, we have to erase this part and let me write down it in more compact form. So in compact form it becomes, so you can write it as summation n equals to 0 to infinity 2 to the power n plus 2 minus 5 to the power n x to the power n. So you can see that when I put n equals to 0, we get 2 to the power 0 plus 2 minus 5 to the power 0. When I put n equals to 1, we get this term. When I put n equals to 2, we get this term. So this is our gx. Now compare gx, what we assume gx is summation n equals to 0 to infinity. We assume that this is n x to the power n. If I compare these two equation, this equation and this equation, you can see that a n is our 2 to the power, so a n is 2 to the power n plus 2 minus 5 to the power n. So this is our solution and here we go. So I think you understand the think of what we have to find that out. So this is the solution. So here the end, so complete. So this is complete the solution procedure to find the solution of the reconciliation. I hope you understand the procedure, the solution procedure. You can see that here we get an, which is 2, and for n greater than equals to 0, if we can put a 0, we will get 3, a 1, we get 3, and in this way we will get the values. So I hope you understand. If you not, please do not forget to comment below in the YouTube. So thank you for watching. So goodbye, and hope you will come back in my next video.